Now that we looked at different scheduling policies, let's discuss the implementation issues of the scheduling policies in an operating system. One possibility is the operating system to maintain a global queue of all the threads that are runnable in the system. And what these processes might do is, when they're ready for work, they'll go to this global queue and pick the next available thread from this queue and run that on itself. And the way we organize the queues is orthogonal to the scheduling policy itself. But if the policy is something like FCFS, it makes sort of logical sense to have a global queue and let the processes pick from the queue. The head of the queue is the earliest arriving thread, and therefore, first come, first serve policy may use this global queue policy. This global queue becomes very infeasible as an implementation vehicle when the size of the multiprocessor is really big, because then it's a huge data structure that all these guys have to access centrally and so on. So typically, what is done is to keep local queues with every processor. And these local queues are going to be based on affinity. And the particular organization of the queues in each of these processes, these local queues for each of these processes, is going to depend on the specific policy that we're going to use. So if it is last processor, or is it fixed processor, or is it the minimum intervening, or is it minimum intervening plus queuing, all of those things will decide how these local queues are going to be maintained. But the important point I want to get across is that in implementing the scheduling policies, you have to have a ready queue of threads from which the processor will pick the next piece of work to do. And the organization of these queues will be based on the specific scheduling policy that you might choose to employ for that scheduler. And it might be that processor P2 runs out of work completely, nothing in its local queue. In that case, it might poll its peers' queues in order to get some work from other guys and run it on that processor. So that's something that might be done. And that is what is called work stealing in the scheduling literature. So that might be something that is commonly employed in a multiprocessor scheduler. So I mentioned that the way these queues are organized is based on policies that the scheduler picks, which might be affinity-based or it might be fairness-based and so on. But in addition to the policy-specific attribute, it might also use additional information in order to organize its queue. In particular, a priority of a thread is determined by three components. Now, one component is the affinity component, assuming it's an affinity-based scheduling policy. But in addition to that, it might also use additional information. So for instance, every thread may be born with a certain priority. So that is the base priority that a particular thread has when it is started up. And as I mentioned, it might depend on whether, the user gave a huge amount of money in order to run his particular thread. So that is the base priority that you associate with a thread. And of course, then you take the affinity into account. And in addition to that, there is age coming in. And this is sort of like a senior citizen discount. If a thread TI has been in the system for a long, long time, you want to get it out of the system as quickly as possible. So what you do is, equivalent to giving a senior citizen discount, you boost the priority of the thread by a certain amount so that it gets to be at the head of the queue and it'll get scheduled on the processor P2. So basically, the priority attribute is what determines the position in the queue for a particular thread. And as I said, three attributes that go with it is the base priority that you may associate with a thread when it is first created, the affinity that it has for a particular processor, and also the senior citizen discount that you might give to a particular thread, depending on how long it's been on the system.